Good afternoon, class. And how are you today? Did somebody say they're not feeling well? Why is that so? I assume you had maybe too much to eat. All right. I trust that you would have had a lovely weekend and a safe one. And I'm happy to see most of you back at school today. Good. Now, our last lesson, we would have looked at what? Can anybody remember? That was just last week. You should be able to remember. Yes, John? Yes, very good. We looked at child abuse. Good, very good. Saski, what did we see or what can you remember was child, we said was child abuse? Mm-hmm. Yes, it's a child being abused. Can you remember anything else? Yes, Ron? Yes, the child can be abused in various ways. For example, let me hear you, Liz. Physically, yes, very good. Mm-hmm. Verbally, yes, a child can be abused verbally. Remember anything else from the lesson last week? All right, yes, we did look at some causes. Very good, Posey, I like that. Good. Now, can anybody give me at least one cause that you can remember? What causes child abuse? Okay, Anna, you seem very quiet today. Tell me something that you remember from last week. Okay, so yes, overcrowded in a home can cause child abuse. Very good, nice, give her a hand for that. She don't usually speak. Good. Now, to begin this lesson this afternoon, I have some newspaper clippings here. Now, I'm going to give to you in your groups. Giving you them, you're going to look at the headline of these articles in these papers. You're going to read them, try to get something from it, right? Try to understand or try to you're going to come up with a topic, which social issue we'll be dealing with today, right? So, group one, here is your clipping. Group two. Remember, you're looking, reading, and trying to tell me, come up with a topic for the lesson. Group three and group four. Good. So you're going to take 4 minutes, go through it, discuss it in your groups, and let's see who can come up with the correct topic or at least come close to it for this afternoon lesson. Good. So take your 4 minutes, read, discuss, and let's proceed. Good. So, time's up. So, let me hear your response now. Group one, we're going to start with you. Based on your article heading, what do you think is the topic for today's lesson? Yes, you're going to read it? Mm-hmm. Man, what is that you have there? Okay, good. Yes, man beats spouse. And he's afraid to report because he's don't want to be stigmatized. And what do you think is the topic for that lesson? Abuse. All right. It has to do with abuse, yes. But we're looking for a next word to go along with abuse. Let's go to group three. What is your article heading? Read it. Suspect accused of butchering wife tried to shove bottle down her throat. Very brutal. What do you think? What did you guys think is that would be the topic for today? Violence. All right. We're getting somewhere. Yes, not a bad try. Nice. Nice. Good. So we have abuse. We have violence. We could probably put the words together and probably we get something later, right? So, the next group, what is your article heading? Yes, very good. Wife stabbed husband as he beats her son. So let me hear, what is your response to that? Abuse in the home. Violence in the home. Okay, so you're saying that the topic has something to do with abuse and violence in the home. All right, nice. You see, we're getting somewhere. I like this. I'm enjoying this. Good. The last group. What is your heading in your newspaper? Woman kills man who chokes her and threatens to burn her. Wow. It's all cruel, eh? Imagine we're seeing this in our newspaper. You buy it to read and this is what you see. Good. So what? Give me your response now. Good. So remember, we have some keywords already. So we have abuse, we have violence, and then the other group say violence in the home. Good. So you're all correct. Where you all made some valid contribution. So you didn't actually come up with the egg. You gave me part of the topic, which is lovely. Thank you guys. Right? Now I'm going to give you the other part of the word which would complete our topic for today. And it begins with D. Yay! See, there you get it. Yes, very good. Lovely. Domestic violence. Yes. Good. Domestic violence. Good. So our topic for today is domestic violence. Now, before we go into that, further into the lesson, we have to find out, or we need to know exactly what is domestic violence. What is it we're dealing with, right? What are we looking for, right? So to help us to arrive at a definition for domestic violence, I have prepared some puzzles here for you to complete for me, right? So I'm going to give it to your group, and I'm going to give you 3 minutes to fill in. It's more like a fill in the blank. So I have it here. This is your puzzle. And then I'm going to give you the words that are missing, right? So you're going to place the words into the correct spot. Now you're going to be given 3 minutes, like I said, to complete. The first part, the first group to complete it, I have something for you. So let's begin. So group one, your puzzle. Yes, kindly pass this to the other group. Just take one each and pass it down. Good. Time's up. So let me see your puzzles. Oh, some person still working? Alright, so those were finished. Two groups. Nice. Let me see the first one. Alright, so the first one read, and you're going to read it for me. I'll read along with you too. Right? Domestic violence is any control behavior the spouse of which is to gain power and threatening over a boyfriend, partner, purpose, girlfriend, or intimate family. Alright, what do you think about this one, class? Pay attention, you get time. Remember, so two groups finish in together. So I have little prizes you're going to get just now, okay? Good. So, what do you think? This is correct? Let me hear your response. You think this defines it, or this is what it's about? Alright, Corville. It's part of it. Alright, so you're saying part is correct. Alright. I agree with you. Part is correct indeed. Nice try. What do you think? Alright, so Mariah, do you think this is the definition, or can we work with it? Or we need to make changes? That's partially correct. Alright, so what happened with it? Yes, the group would have put some words in spaces where they're not supposed to be. However, yes, that happened. They kind of mixed it up a bit. But it was a good effort. Good try, right? Give them a hand for that. They still would get prizes anywhere. Right? Good. So the second group, let me see yours. Alright. Alright, so class, look here. The second group. Let's read it. Domestic violence is any threatening behavior, the purpose of which is to gain power and control over a spouse, partner, boyfriend or girlfriend, or intimate family. Wow, kind of like this. Yes, nice. Well done. So give them a hand. They would have put all the words in the correct spaces. Nice. Great job. Well done. So let's examine the keywords in the definition, right? So the first one we have here is domestic. What does that tell you? Domestic. When we say domestic, think about it. Domestic. We say we're looking at the okay, did you complete your domestic chores? We're having domestic problems. What are they talking about?
House
what
problem.
Are what are they saying? Okay, so Miranda, yes, good, very good, lovely, good. When domestic means it's happening in the home. Nice. Give her a clap for that. I like that. Good. Good. So domestic violence, and like Miranda said, that it takes place in the home. Good. So domestic violence is any threatening behavior. Threatening. When someone threatens you, what happened? Or if you feel threatened, how do you feel? Let me hear you. Angel, you feel scared. Okay, what about you, Mark? How do you feel when, if you feel, you say you feel threatened? Okay, you're scared for your life. Okay, good. So threatening, they threaten, you feel scared. Exactly, right? Behavior, the purpose. Good. So let's take it from the top again. Domestic violence is any threatening behavior. The purpose of which is to gain power. Go again. Power. And yes, control. Power and control. Two big words, huh? Good. When you talk here about power, when you hear about power, what comes to your mind? Yes, okay, Romel. You feel like you have okay, nice. Power. You have power. It means that you have a lot of authority. Very good. Nice. You understand. And if someone tells you that you're in control, Kosi, what are they saying to you there? You're in charge. Yes. Very good. Yes. You're in charge of it. So it's the purpose of which is to gain power and control over a spouse. Let me get that again. Spouse. Who is a spouse? Let me hear you. Who do you think is a spouse? Oh, Nirmala? Mommy? Why do you say your mommy is a spouse? Why do you refer to her as a spouse? Okay, because she is your? Good. Yes, nice. She is your father's wife. Good. Partner. The other key word here is partner. Partner. If you say it's a partner, it means that it's for two. Yes. Thank you. Thank you. I like you. You're really giving me, what I'm looking for today. I like that. Good. Partner, two or more. You said two persons and you're working together in a partnership. Okay. You're using your business brain on me here today. Partnership, giving me big words. But I like that. Nice. Good. Boyfriend or girlfriend or intimate family. Right? Good. So it's doesn't look at the word spouse. You say, like Nirmala said, it's her mommy, because it's her mommy is her father's wife. So it doesn't necessarily mean that it's happening in the home. Keywords here, it's happening in the home. It makes the person feel scared, and the purpose of this act is to gain power and control over the persons within your house. Good. And it doesn't have to be two couple that are married. That's what they're saying here, right? You remember you have different types of homes. Not everybody in this home would be married. Sometimes the one partner is just visiting. And then in some cases, it could happen among you too. You have boyfriend, you have girlfriends. Isn't that so, right? Because so it involves. And, well, that point is not here, but I must say that it can happen within the home. It can happen among children. The parents beating on the children, siblings beating on each other, and so on. Right? Good. So take this down for me quickly. Good. So moving on to the next part of our lesson, we'll be looking at the different forms of domestic violence or the different ways in which domestic violence can take place or occur. Right? So on the board here, I have a concept map. For now, we just have the middle complete, right? I'm going to show you a video and you pay keen attention. Pay attention to everything, because based on this video here now, it will help you to come up or derive at what are the different forms of domestic violence, right? So look at the video and then I'm going to give you a next activity to do. Alright, good. So after you finish viewing the video, among yourselves in your groups, you're going to discuss the different forms that you see. Now I'm going to give you pieces of papers. You're going to write the different forms of it for me, and then you're going to come and we're going to finish our concept map, right? So pay attention to the video.
Beth, do you part?
I do.
Well, maybe I wouldn't have to worry about other guys looking at you if you didn't dress like a whore.
I just don't know what I would do if you were with anyone but me.
Where you been?
You look at me when I'm talking to you, do you hear me?
Look, I didn't want to do that. You just don't listen.
Who's that?
Hey! You sure you're okay? I'm fine.
Who's gonna take you in but me? You will never see your son again.
How about next time? I make sure you never leave the house again.
I just picked up a couple of things I thought.
You know we're on a budget.
It was just a few things I thought that we needed.
Doesn't look like a couple of bloody things to me. Looks like you did a whole bloody shop. Blowing the budget. How are we gonna get ahead, Anna, if you just keep spending and spending? Huh?
Girl, you shouldn't cover your face. You're looking like a fucking vampire. Huh?
Please.
Calm down.
So, from the video, I assume you would have learned a lot, right? Good. So, looking at it, you would be able to, you know, relate to what is happening today. Yes, Mark, you want to say something? Oh, yeah, yes. Your neighbor usually beats his wife. Wow, yes. And this is something that is happening on a daily basis, right? It might not be happening in my home. It might not be happening in your home. But it's happening. And if you look at, if you've been following the news and so on, you would have seen how drastic and how brutal it is, right? So it's definitely an issue, and it's not affecting the victims alone. It's affecting us. You might say, okay, well, we don't have anything to do with it. But when you look at it, of course it's affecting us. Like when Mark sees his neighbor beating his wife. How do you feel, Mark? Sad? Mm-hmm. You get angry. All right, good. So you see, it's affecting everyone in society. Good. So the forms now that you would have got from the video. Let me hear. Group 2, give me the first answer. Alright. Sexual. Okay. I like this one. So we're gonna put this one here. The next group. Wow. Physical. Nice. Okay. The other group. You have here economic. Wow, you really paid attention to that video. Honestly, I can see that. You like movies. Alright, so angel, social, okay. Yes, Kosi, let me see yours. Emotional, nice. Okay. And the last paper came back blank. Not good. Anywhere. Good. So these are the types that you would have noticed, or the types that you know, right? You have sexual, social, emotional, physical, and economic. This is what you see from the video. Or maybe, yes, the video had most of it inside. Good. Now what I'm gonna, I have three here of my own. And I wasn't sure whether you would have arrived at it, so I put it to one side. Good. Have you ever heard about this one? Spiritual? No? Alright. Oh, Romel, you did. Okay, are you going to tell me what's it about just now? Good. This is our next form. Persons can be in abused spiritually. And then you have psychological. Now, where you have emotional, we're going to move this one from here. Most times in textbooks or on the internet and so on, these two go hand in hand. You wouldn't see psychological, or sometimes you see emotional, you don't see psychological, right? It's practically the same. They have the same effect on the victim. And then the last one here is, yeah, I like this word, right? Has to do with technology. Yes. Technological. Just so you can be abused technologically now. Good. So we have them here. So our concept map complete. Is there anybody else that think there's a next form and you want to share with us? Any other form? What am I hearing there? Malaika? Verbal? Yes, you're correct. Nice, nice. You're well. I like that. You people have been reading and so on, you know? Verbal. However, there are different ways in which that takes. It would fall under one of the heading right here. And in our discussion, it's going to come out, right? So they can be abused verbally as well. Right, so let's just fix this here properly so that you can see it. Good. So we have, remember these are not all the forms. You just give me a few here. So we're going to work with this for today. So if you go on the internet, Google textbooks and so on, you're going to see other forms, right? But from the video, these were the ones that you said that can be fine. You'll be found there, right? Good. So we're going to give examples of these now, right? So I have some examples here, and I'm going to give you them in groups. Now you're going to quickly come out and paste them. Like, for example, the first one here, denying access to money. Where do you think this would fall, right? So I'm going to give you four to a group, and you're going to quickly come up and stick them on where you think, under which, whether if it's social, sexual, spiritual, right? Good. So take and pass. All right, good. So you would have completed your activity. Nice. I like what I'm seeing. Good. So we have the different forms, and then you would have put the examples under what you think would be examples of the different types. So, nice. Well, well done. Give yourself a hand for that. Lovely. I wish if I had a lot of candies today, everybody would have gotten something. Because you're doing good. Great job. Keep it up. Good. So let's just ensure that the examples are under the correct heading, right? So let's look at the first one, social. And you have hiding family asset, restricting from activities, being in confinement, being humiliated or insulting. All right? Let me hear you, Elizabeth. Do you think that this is in all of these areas correct? Yes, no? Some of it? All right. So tell me which one you think or which one is not in the correct spot. The last one, being humiliated or insulted. Okay, you're saying that we should move it. And where do you think we should put it wrong? All right, so I'm taking it down. And where are we going to put it wrong? Emotional. Nice. Thank you. Lovely. All right, so we're going to put that being humiliated and insulting on this one here. That goes with emotional. Why did you say that, Ron? Why? Why did you say we must put it here? Okay. Good. So if somebody insults you, you feel how? Sad, hurt. Okay, nice. Good. I like that. Good. So this one here, it affects if somebody insults you, you feel shy. Thank you, Malaika. You feel shy or you feel ashamed. Good. So, and then if they insult you, you don't feel nice, right? You feel like running in a hole. Maybe you don't ever come out back or come out till when everybody's gone, right? Good. Let's look at... Yes, Carvel? How may I help you? Oh, I see. The very first one on the social is in its wrong. All right, nice. Very good, Carvel. Thank you. Hiding family asset. Rohini, where do you think we should put this one? And tell me why also. Hiding family asset. Under. Oh, you're very smart. Asset has to do with money. Smart girl. Nice. Good. So, and money has to do with what? Oh, Kosi, you seem to be there. Good. Money has to do with the money man. Asset, a lot of asset. If somebody say you have asset, it means that you have a lot of money. And the word there that would best go with this one would be economic. So we're going to put this under economic. So let's quickly just stick this in here. Good. What about the other two? Do you think they're in the correct spot? Okay, good. Yes, they are. Being restricted from activity, social. You're not allowed to socialize. People got party, you can't go. You want to go to probably shop? No, you can't go, right? You're restricted. They tell you have to stay home. And in some homes, you're going to find that. All right, you want something? I'll get it for you. The husband might say, okay, I'll get it for you. Why do you think they don't want the wives to go out in this case? Right? They don't want them to socialize. Why they don't want you to mix and so on in society? Oh. Yes, Anthony. They want to be in control. Correct. Right? So by restricting them now, saying that, no, you can't go, it tells you that, okay, you're by yourself, right? So these two are in their correct spot. They restrict you, you're in isolation. And one other reason also, they don't want you to mix because people might tell you things or you probably go out and say that, okay, X, Y, and Z is happening in my home. Then your friend might say, no, I don't think that should be happening. That's not right, right? So it's like they're going to tell you things now, and you're gonna see things differently. And then you eventually you will expose, you know, or you tell, you make people know. You probably don't even know. And in most cases, right, what you're gonna find is that victims, they're not even aware that they're being abused, or you know, and they think that it's okay. It's okay for that to happen. You get too slapped, it's because I didn't have the teeth. You tell you stupid, yeah, maybe indeed I am stupid, so I take it, and that's cool. But it's not cool, right? But it's not okay. The second one, technological. And under this one here, smart children, all to were in their right spot, hacking into partner online account, right? So you have your phone, you put it down, get the person Facebook password, you hack in. What you want to see, what he or she is doing, right? Now bear in mind, and I need to remind you that domestic violence, it can happen to both parties. It can be the male, it can be the female, right? Good. So there is it. Cosi put his phone down. Malaika wants to see if he's having, you know, any other girlfriend or maybe an ex partner somewhere. She picks it up, get the password, go into it, and there, blam. Let's say that Angel sent Cosi a nice morning message, and Malaika feel that this is not appropriate. I don't like this. So Malaika now is gonna reply using other words to see how Angel would, you know, respond to that message, right? Another thing, she can probably post something. Remember, she has access to his account now. She can probably post something, a nude picture, some message, you know, things like that. Tracking partner device. In our society today, technology can do a lot. While it can be a good thing, it can also be a very bad thing, right? Well, now this was a new one that they would have recognized recently. You can be abused domestically using technological devices, right? They track you, they get your password, go into your account, they post things that you aren't aware about, message people for you, you know, and things like that. Good. The other one is sexual. And yeah, laughing, yeah, I see this word. Something wrong? Oh yeah, I like the word. Alright. Let's see what the word is about. Being forced to participate in degrading sexual activities. Alright, now I see why you are laughing. What are sexual activities? Anthony, kissing. Mark said rubbing up. Alright, we're getting somewhere. Alright, calm down. Good. So, degrading sexual activities. It means that the person is not comfortable doing it, right? But he or she might be forced into doing it. Now, I'm going to ask you something, and you're going to respond to me. Do you think that persons can be, that a wife, or within a marriage, do you think that someone can be raped within a marriage? Let me hear your opinions. Yes, no, maybe. Corville? Yes, wow, you're bold. Why did you say they can be? Very good, Corville, very good. If I had a large chocolate, you would have gotten that today. Very good, I like that response. Good, because he or she doesn't want to do it, but, yes, and his word that got my attention, their consent, sexual activity without consent, right? So if I say no, it means no. No means no, right? Good, but then you don't want to hear no. And you force me. That was without my consent. And you can be charged for that. So yes, in a marriage, persons can be charged for having sexual activities without consent. You're not willing to participate then, right? Being forced to watch pornographic materials, right? You throw on your big screen TV and you got all the fancy position and everything there in front of you, you know? And then when you're done now, you're touching me. Hey, let me go try it now. You're laughing. All right. I hope these things don't happen in your home, you know, man. Right? Because if it is happening, it's not right. That is the fact here. It's not right, right? Spiritual. Being prevented from practicing one religion. And this was the only option we had there. Okay, nice, good. So, let's say the person is Hindu and probably married a Christian or a Muslim person, spouse. They come in, probably fool him or her that, yes, you come. You will get your altar, you will get to pray, you will get to play a bhajan. After the wedding, now, nice time done. I can't play me bhajan, I can't light my agarbatti. Problem, blows, right? Good. So that person there now is being prevented from practicing his or her religion, right? Physical. And we have strangling and burning, slapping and punching, restricting one from being around others. And then you have attack using weapons. Now we have strangling and burning. Physical means these are the things that you can see, right? You see a mark, a cut, maybe a punch. Or some fingers on somebody's face, they get a hard box, right? Good. Attack using weapon, some bottle, knife, cutlass. And in our society today, so many things, you know, they hang strangling them, hanging them, and all of that. Very bad. Now look at this one here, restricting one from being around others. Do you think that one is in its right spot, Cassie? It is? Anthony, what do you think? It's in its right spot? Why do you say no? Okay. It has to do more with socialization. Very good. I like that, Emily. Good. So we're going to put this one here, right? Being restricted from being among others. Remember we went through this? So we're saying that they don't want you to be around people. Keep you away from your family, your friends. Because they're afraid that those persons might influence you. The other part we have here is economic. And like Kosi said before, this has to do with money, right? So how is it you can be abused economically? The first one you have is denying one from work or school. Now if you don't want me to work, how is it I'm getting money? I wouldn't have money, right? There and then you get control over me because I gotta beg you. I want a new shoe, I gotta ask you. I want a new phone, but you're buying for yourself, you know. Right? Good. Denying access to money. If you would have noticed earlier in the video that there was, when she came in with the grocery, and then he was saying that, okay, she was overspending and so on, right? And imagine the things that she would have purchased there would be things he would be having probably for dinner or lunch. But he still has a problem with that because what? He's working for the money. So he would tell you, okay, you should only buy 1 pound flour instead of 2 pound. Right? That's how they feel they're in control. Power and control. Right? Good. The other one here is hiding family asset. Alright, you got 2 or 3 bank accounts. But your wife only know about one. Or you got some land your grandfather give you. Big acres. You're the owner of a tractor and maybe a combine. But there is it. Auntie Shelley, you know nothing about them. Nothing. Poor Auntie Shelley living in one house. And she think, well, this is all you got. Right? Lo and behold, you're a rich man or you're a rich woman somewhere there. Right? Economically, you don't have access to money and so on. They bully you in that case. Right? Like we said, if you were not working, then you're solely depending on the person, right? And in most cases, persons tend to stay in such situation because they feel they cannot do better. There's nothing they can do for themselves, right? The last one here is emotional and psychological. And you would have put name calling and mocking. Yes, they tell you, you're stupid. They're mocking you. Cheating or being too jealous, right? Probably you are the one that has maybe a degree. You have a degree, you have a master, you have, you know, and there is it now, the man or the woman. Okay, let's use the female in this case. Let's say she's the one she's the owner of the house. She has a nice fancy job, lovely car. But there you are now, you come from some gutter down environment. So she bring you now and put you up nice, you know. She dressing up nice, she smelling nice, she got fancy friends. right? She going out more. One time you the home, you got borrow she car and things like that. Y'all don't laugh. This is serious business. It actually happens, right? Good. So you get jealous now, like I am nothing, you know? You start creating problems, right? You start creating problems like, what is it? Her money falls on the table. The table shake when you come on, it didn't even move, right? So you become insecure and you start to create problems within the home. Right? Monitor your phone call or text. Pling, pling, the phone ring. You're gone, you talk. You didn't even talk easy. They heard the whole conversation, you know. But it's hood up. Hood up. It's my friend. What I want? What are you calling this hour for? Things like that. Right? Or you put on your phone and you slip in the bathroom. There. Uncle Harry, pick it up. Check in, you know. Who you converse with. What was said and things like that. This one would have went through that before. Good. So I'm gonna give you a big hand now for this. You have done a great job, right? Nice, lovely. Good. So you make your short notes quickly in your book, or you probably would have already done that. Nice.
One.
Alright, good. So now we're gonna move on to the causes of domestic violence, or what can actually lead up of the one being abused, right? Now, based on the video that you would have seen and completing the concept map, we did discussion on the different forms, and then you gave examples and so on, right? Good. So let me hear your answers now. What do you think can cause domestic violence within a home? Think of it. Yes, Rohini, you're all ready to go. Let me hear your answer. Rum. Alright, nice. Rum. Good. Lovely. I like that. Rum. Good. So yes, rum, which is, or you say rum or alcohol, and that can cause someone. Rohini, why did you say that? Oh, because Uncle Charlie, when he drunk, he just beat Auntie Betty down the street. Good. Nice. Good answer. Right? Good. So, the one there, what we're going to put that into one heading, right? You say rum, so we're going to say it's substance abuse, right? So it could be the person's abusing alcohol, person is smoking, and you know the different things that they can smoke. When they actually abuse their partner, they're not in their full or right sense, right? So we say substance abuse. Good. Give me a next one, Angel. Unemployment within a home. Alright, good. Yes. Good. So unemployment would make persons feel how? If you have a home, daddy ain't working, mommy ain't working, what happens? Oh, lovely, Malaika. Good. It becomes stressful. Good. So stress within a home can cause domestic violence. Nice, nice, nice. I'm enjoying this today. Good. Yes, Carville? You feel like you're not worth it. Oh, you feel worthless in society. So you endure all the abuse. Yes, you're correct, Carville. It means then that if you feel that you're not worthy of this thing, right? He slap you, he kick you, he burn you. It's okay, man. It's okay. You feel that your self-worth in society, it's not, well, you know, maybe this is good for me then. What's happening? It's good for me. I am causing it. It therefore means, students, that you have low self-esteem. Right? Low self-esteem. Right? Good. So we're going to put this here. You feel worthless. Right? Low self-esteem. You don't think or you feel what is happening to you, you're the person responsible for that. Good. Yes, Romel? Ooh. Yes, Romel, I would need some cell phone, TV. Alright, good. So these things would be mass media. When you put them on the mass media, your cell phone, your radio, your TV, your tablets, your computer, right? These are mass media, right? Good. Now, how does that influence persons? Yes, Rona? You give me some. I'm not too, you know, familiar with that one. Okay. Yes, you're correct. What you see, you practice. You see, in some movie, the woman, like for example, take this movie, Enough. Many of you probably know about it, with Jennifer Lopez and so on. You know, at first it was okay, couple swap, and then when it get intense, that's when she couldn't take it anymore, right? But so you see that in the movie, now you decide to try it. Let me see if it will work in my relationship, right? And you put swap, in some cases you don't get swap back, no joke, right? Good. So the media can influence you to actually abuse your partner as well, right? So we say influence of mass media. The mass media could be newspapers, magazines, cell phones, and so on. Good. Anything else? Come on, think. Anything else? Oh, okay, Anthony. Alright, so you're saying if the person don't know or is not aware of what he or she is doing, it's wrong, in some cases. So you're saying the person is not knowledgeable enough, right? Probably they're doing this, but they don't know that, okay, this is wrong. Alright, but so now under that one there, the lack of education, we're going to put that under this heading here. Lack of education can cause persons to be, like for example, the person probably didn't went to school much, so there wasn't that amount of interaction, socialization. What are you going to find in society? What you're going to find in society, right, is that persons who would have been a little bit more educated, they tend to understand. Instead, I coughing, she, and look like she goes away. But persons who barely went to school and worse yet if they're living under poverty and so on, they tend to, you know, lash out like that, right? So persons don't use the initiative and they say, okay, man, this is just things. All right, we can't live together anymore. You go, I go this way, and that's it. They're thinking different then. They're being rational. But some people's like, no, I can't get you, nobody else can't get you, right? Slit your throat, hang you, dump you in a barrel, and all these kind of things. Good. Any other answer? All right, so I'm going to give you a few more to wrap up. And this one here, we have abuse cycle. And this one here basically has to do with, all right, it keeps passing. Now, you know what's a cycle, right? It keeps going over and over. Good. So within a home now, you might find the person, the person was living in a home, brought up in a home, where the father punching and kicking at the mother. There you have the son and the daughter, right? He grows up now, married. He see mommy used to take it. All used to be okay. So he continued it. It's a cycle. His child is going to see it. The daughter saw that her mother took it and said nothing. She accepted it, right? So when her husband take, marry her now, carry her away and so on, if he gives it 2 slap or something, she's like, that's normal. It's normal to her. But reality is, it's not normal, right? Good. The other one is jealousy and possessiveness. Like I gave you the example earlier where you might have, one partner income is more, one partner family is more wealthy, or in some cases, the man get jealous, especially if your wife looking nice, you know, when you walking down the street, people whistling, awesome you get in, right? You know what? Suddenly tell you, well, the pants too tight, you can't wear it no more, the skirt too short, that can't work, right? So he becomes jealous, and you know he's gonna want to clothe her all over, big gong she wearing, so nobody ain't sipping off she no more. Y'all laughing this thing, alright, good. The other one I have here is domestic service, domestic servants. Good. Before you got married, take your wife, you're washing your own brief, cleaning your own boots, washing your plate and so on. All of a sudden now, yes, you get white, you get slave, eh? Some people think of it like that. It's like, all right, I finished eating, left my plate there. Sherry, move it for me, please. You come with your boots, you kick it in the car, and your business, because you know somebody there now to pick it up, clean it, and pack it up for you, right? Both of you working, everybody working, coming home late, but you still expect that because she is a woman in the house, that's your wife, you still expect a hot plate of dinner by 6 o'clock. Bear in mind, you're being very unreasonable there because you started to work, you work the same hours of the day, so you come home, but there is a demand, come home, take off your clothes, TV, or his cell phone in some cases. And there now, before you rest your foot, you got a baby crying, somebody homework you gotta do, you still gotta cook and get everything in order, right? But then he feel he don't work, he do enough for the day. Not reasonable, right? Not good. So the other one, the last one here, is believe that males are dominant. Now traditionally, males would have been the sole breadwinners within a home, right? So they believe now, because they are the sole breadwinners, they are the one bringing in all the money and everything, they make all the decisions. So whatever they say, you go by that, right? So you depend on them. So dominant, okay, I am the man, it's my money, what I say goes, right? Good. So these are some possible causes. There are other causes, there are other reasons that can cause domestic violence within a home. However, I just give you a few here, right? And you can write them down quickly. Good. All right, good. So now to wrap up our lesson, you're going to do a little activity for me, right? So on the pieces of paper, check under your desk, you have square pieces of paper. Oh, yeah, I don't find it. See? Yes, yeah, you're very alert. Good. So you're going to write a message on the piece of paper for me, right? The message is, so if you look around, and I've noticed that earlier, there are some persons absent for some reason or the other. So those persons know you're writing a message to them about today's lesson, what you would have learned, right? So when they read this message now, they must be able to, it's like they didn't miss anything then, right? They didn't miss anything much from the class, because in that message there, you would have told them that, okay, we looked at domestic violence, maybe what is it, and everything else you can remember from the lesson, right? A short message, not a whole book or a whole page, right? So write that for me quickly. And then you're going to share, some of you would share your messages with the class. Good.
One.
Good. So you finish writing the messages now. Good. So I'm going to ask a few of you to volunteer to read what you would have written there to your colleagues who are not here today. Good. So Angel, start with your one. Mm-hmm. So domestic violence is... Uh-huh. Continue. Appropriate behavior in the home. Mm-hmm. Good. It caused fear. Alright. No problem. You have... Good. Nice. Lovely. Right? So if I should go over that again. Just hold for me, Angel. So domestic violence is inappropriate behavior in a home that happens. Okay. Good. And it causes fear. Right? Good. Continue reading your message. It takes different forms, such as physical, emotional, sexual. All right, nice. Economic, good, nice. Continue, I'm listening. So substance abuse or drug abuse can cause it. Followed by... Read, we're listening, you read. Lack of education, low self-esteem. All right, good. Thank you very much, Angel. I like that, right? Good. Carville, can you give us, let me hear your message that you wrote for your colleagues, your classmates who are absent today. Okay, domestic violence, threatening behavior towards a spouse, or children, or sibling within a home. All right, good. Some possible causes are, all right, you have low self-esteem, drug abuse, lack of education, jealousy. Nice. Social media. All right, good. Thank you very much, Carvel. Nice. Good. So, Romel, your own would be the last, I'll take. So, domestic violence is inappropriate behavior within a home. It can involve both male and female, as well as children. All right, good. It takes the following form, sexual, emotional, physical, economic. Good. Good. Anything else you wrote there? Yes, it can be caused by stress, lack of education, unemployment. Yes, can work. Low self-esteem. Anything else? Influence of mass media. All right. And abuse cycle. All right, good. All right. Thank you very much. Give yourself a round of applause. All right. So, since the population, or you were so few in class today, I checked my prizes, and each one of you can have one. So, I'm going to pass this down to the class now. Take one. One only, because I count you. So if somebody didn't get it, means someone took two, right? Good. And thank you very much. Please go home safe and enjoy the rest of your afternoon.